This screencast is going to go over an example of a user-defined function in VBA. We're going to create a piecewise function here. The function name is going to be interval. It's going to output y according to the following constraints. So when x is greater than 9, we're going to calculate y with one formula. If x is between 0 and 9, we're going to calculate it as 10x plus 10. And then if x is less than 0, y is going to be 10. One of the first steps to any sort of sub or function, we're creating a function, is to set up a flowchart. We have start, so we're starting this program. We're inputting x, and that's going to come in the form of x is going to be input into the function name, because in Excel, the user is just going to write in equals interval of x. So that's going to be the input. And then we are going to do a couple conditional statements. We have a decision here. Whenever we have a decision, that's a diamond. Is x greater than 9? So if you recall, when x is greater than 9, the function value is going to be 15 times root 4x plus 10, and so on. So the first thing, we see if x is greater than 9. If so, we calculate y to be equal to that in terms of x, and then we move along. If x is not greater than 9, so it's less than 9 or equal to 9, then we go to another decision point. So we have another decision point here. Is x greater than or equal to 0? If that's true, then we calculate y using the second formula, 10x plus 10. If x is not greater than or equal to 0, and in that case, y is just equal to 10. And then you'll notice that all of these sort of come back together to the central junction here. And then after that, we are going to display or output our y, and then we finish it up with an end. So these are typical flowchart elements. So in Excel, we can go and create a new module. I open up the editor, and what I've done is I've already created a new module, so you can insert a new module to get to here. Start it with function. The argument of my interval function, which is the name, is x. This can really be anything, it's just used internally in this function. The next thing I need to do is dim things other than the input. If I leave it like this, the editor is going to assume that it's a variant type, but if I want to force it to be something like a double, I can write it in there. So I'll just leave it as double there. That's not really necessary. If I'm working with any other variables that are going to be in my code, then I need to declare. So y is going to be the output, and that is going to be double. Going back to the flowchart, I've input x, I've declared things. Now I have this diamond, and a diamond is an if-then. So I know that I'm going to have an if, and the first one is if x is greater than 9, then I'm going to define the output, which is y, is going to be equal to 15 times the root 4 of x plus 10. Now, what if x is not greater than 9? Well, we can put in an else if. So else if x is greater than or equal to 0, then y is equal to 10 times x plus 10. That was the second piece of our piecewise function. And then finally, if it's not greater than 9, it's not greater than 0, that means it must be less than 0. So we're working now with this lower portion here. So we have the if here, and then we have the else if here, and then the else is really like what you do if nothing else, and that's y is equal to 10. So else y equal 10. All if statements need an end if, so we have to end if, and now we are back. This is the end if, this junction here. That's our end if, and now the last thing we need to do is display this before we terminate. So to display, the output of the function is always the name of the function. That's what's going to be placed into the cell in Excel. So I'm just going to say interval equal y. I could write this a little bit easier. Instead of defining a new variable y, I could just write interval here equals that. And in that case, I would also put interval equals this. So I'm replacing all the y's with interval, and I wouldn't have to have this line, and I wouldn't have to have this line. But sometimes it makes more sense just to sort of make intermediates that then you can use as your output. So the output of the function is interval, and that's going to be y. So we're ready to go. I'm going to go back over to Excel. I put in a bunch of values for x, and now we're going to calculate y using our interval. So I start typing in interval. It recognizes interval here, so I can double-click on that. That's a user-defined function. And now I'm just going to do the interval of our x value. I press enter, and it returns a y. So is that consistent with our original piecewise function? If x is less than 0, which it is, it's negative 10, it should be 10. So it looks like our function interval is working properly. And now I can drag this down. That's one nice thing about user-defined functions. You can just easily drag these things down like you would any other function that's built into Excel. And if I wanted to plot this, I could just insert a chart, a scatter chart, if I wanted to, a line chart, and so on. This is how you can create and use user-defined functions in VBA.